New tonight, we now know several couples on their way to a birthday celebration all died when their limousine crashed this weekend.
20 fatalities is just horrific.
I just hope they didn't suffer.
Tony, how's Katie?
I want to believe it was instant.
Investigators say the driver failed to stop at an intersection, crashed into an SUV. Two people near the SUV and all 18 inside the limo died. That does include the driver. New York State officials say the driver did not have the right license to drive the limo, and the limousine he was driving had failed inspection last month. Officials claim it was not supposed to be on the road in the first place.
Tonight, NBC2's Joanna Boris is uncovering what credentials a driver needs to have to operate a limousine in Florida.
I stopped by Elite Limousine Service tonight in Fort Myers to find out what it would take for me to be able to drive a limo. They say anyone with a driver's license could get into a limo that carries up to 14 people or less and legally get on the road. But the owners say they think the guidelines should be much stricter.
If you have a license to drive, you're legal to get behind the wheel of these vehicles.
Rick Scott and his wife Sue own Elite Limousine Service in Fort Myers. They have 5 stretch limousines, a 14-passenger limo bus, and 2 town cars.
Most companies just hire somebody that you could drive it, and of course they're going to say yes.
But Rick says driving a car is very different from driving a limo.
You go to pick a client up, and you're driving an empty vehicle. You put 10 people in the vehicle, you could have 2,500 pounds. Now you've got to consider takeoffs and stopping with that additional weight.
Which is why he and his wife require their chauffeurs to go through intensive training.
Background checks. The vehicles are also inspected twice yearly, once by the insurance company and once by Lee County for permitting.
And if they break the rules,
like they're speeding or something, a client will call up and say, we're bouncing all over the car. That's it, that driver's done.
Each vehicle has a GPS which sends the owners notifications when a driver does something wrong.
If they go over 75, my GPS gives me a hit on the AOL, and the next thing you know, I'm calling them up.
If you want to drive a limo that carries more than 14 people, you need to get a CDL or a commercial license, which has several requirements. This includes holding a permit for 14 days, submitting your driving record, general knowledge test, and a road test, just to name a few. Live in the newsroom, Joanna Boris, NBC2.